Hello everybody, this is Daz from Thailand Wild. This is the last clip that I filmed in 2020. Good riddance to that year. And a happy new year to everyone and good luck for 2021. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do so. And of course, we're always very happy to receive comments from wildlife enthusiasts. Today we've come up into Tong Pa Pom National Park once again, this time right at the top, close to the village of Bilok. And we are following a stream that's not far from the road, down through the forest. Almost immediately, Alex has come across this stream skink. We think it might be a Birdmoor's water skink, but we're still not 100% sure about that. Absolutely amazing to watch it foraging in and out of the water here on the side of a stream. Astonishing. It's kind of bouncing up and down with a lot more though when I use this.
That's also my hand.
Yeah.
A whole load of lines there. They're the whitish lines, at least reflecting white from the belly right up onto the throat.
After this, we filmed numerous frog species along the side of the water, and I have added the names of some of those frogs in the description below the video.
Yes. Well, tonight we've come up to the top of Tong Pa Phuong National Park. I think the altitude is around about 800 or 900 meters up here. The reason we've come up this high is because we want to try and find something different. We know down at lower altitudes there are a lot of white-lipped pit vipers here. We've seen them. Many years ago, I found a dead snake quite high up, and I thought it was a Pope's pit viper. I've always wondered if I was right about that, and tonight, after several hours of searching, at last we found one. There it is, right there, on this piece of bamboo. Just the prettiest sight you can imagine. Absolutely no doubt, a Pope's pit viper.
It's such a wonderful thing when you actually find the target species that you were after. We were so hoping that we would find one of these Pope's pit vipers up here. And look at this one. What a beautiful snake. This is a male, of course. You can see here it has the white and red ventrolateral stripe on the side of the body. Red eye, which is one of the diagnostic features of this species, at least in adults.
You know what you do get for this thing?
What's that?
One of those little, like, gorilla tripods.
Yeah.
Those little teeny things for cell phones. Totally,
yeah.
Adjustable.
Yeah, that would be good. And probably a lot better than the bamboo cane that I had before. And then only a few minutes later, I was filming another couple of frogs on a leaf, and I called Alex over to have a look, and he turned around and spotted immediately next to him another Pope's pit viper, another male. This little frog appears to be completely oblivious to its danger. Here, another Pope's pit viper, a juvenile. Notice that the eye is not red yet. This one just has the white stripe on the side of the body. So presumably a female. Well, one of the really interesting things that I learn when I'm out with other people tonight, and I'm out with Alex, I've noticed he always looks under stuff, in stuff, around stuff, the places I don't generally look. And of course, if I always just look in the easiest to look places, I'm just going to see the most common species, the species that you can most easily find. And just now he's come into the forest, away from the stream where we've been traveling. He's looked down into this little rotten stump, which I probably would have just passed by. There's a pool of water in the bottom of it, and a gorgeous little frog living down there on the side, on the inside of this little hollow stump. We're fairly confident of the ID on this one. We think it's a Boulanger's tree frog, appropriately named.
Quite big.
And then after about 6 hours of filming, we were heading back to the car, and this Pope's pit viper swam across the stream right in front of me. Pretty sure it's the first one that we saw earlier on in the night.